What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Exotic Astrology again, and today we will discuss symptoms of a debilitated, afflicted, terrible, miserable, downtrodden Jupiter. What happens when Jupiter is in a bad dignity in somebody's chart? It's also a funny video where we will not discuss on the astrological combinations of where Jupiter is debilitated, or how, or when, or why it is not. Alright, this is not a video on all those combinations and placements and aspects and afflictions that we will discuss in some other video. But today we will discuss, irrespective of your Jupiter's placement, if you have all these symptoms, well, that means your Jupiter is in trouble and we have to work on it. Therefore, if you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it below. And if you are interested in doing some donation for the sustenance of this channel, then you're most welcome to go to PayPal in the comments below and do some donation. Or if you want a personal consultation with me one-to-one, then please contact me in my email. Now, before beginning, as I say, God is there with you all the time. Just look to Him and He will help you overcome the effects of a terrible Jupiter. Well, what is the number one symptom, the end of it all, the first? Let's throw the bomb now. The bomb is going to fall. And before I start, if you have any questions on any other videos, then also let me know in the comments. What is the first symptom? The first symptom of a difficult Jupiter is you do not like the idea of God. You do not like the idea of a supreme being who is the ultimate controller, because Jupiter is the significator of God, spirituality, religion, wisdom. These are the higher significations of Jupiter. Faith, benevolence, all these are traits. Expansion, growth, these are the traits. That is the first symptom. You somehow do not like the idea of God. You probably are an atheist, or to be worst, you may be a skeptic. Or skeptic doesn't mean that, to not be a skeptic, it doesn't mean that you just believe something which anybody tells you. But whenever somebody is realized in the conclusion of the scriptures, even when they speak, you still doubt them. That is the second symptom. You always doubt the word of the scriptures. Always. Either you are a Hindu, or you are a Muslim, or you are a Christian, or you are a Zoroastrian, or a Buddhist, or anybody. You always doubt the word of the scriptures. You cannot put faith. It is terribly difficult for you to put faith in the word of the scriptures. Oh my God, how can that be true? See, there's the story of a frog in the well. Do you know about that story? If you don't, I will tell you. There was once a frog in the well. In a well, as you say in Hindi. Well is kuwa, I guess. So there was a frog once, and one of his friend, another frog, had come from the Pacific Ocean. And he came and told to this frog that, my dear sir, do you know there is a very big ocean? And then this frog who stays in the well, he said, what? What do you mean by ocean? What is the meaning of ocean? And then this friend told, my dear friend, you can't imagine, that ocean is so big. It is millions of times bigger than this well where you are living. Now this frog who used to live in the well, he not only used to live there, but his mentality was also like that well. Because he used to always stay there, and he used to jump from here to there within the well. Pung, 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 like this. Have you seen how frogs jump? It looks very funny, at least to me. So then what happened is, this frog who used to stay in the well, for him it was next to impossible to believe that there is something called as a Pacific Ocean. Which is maybe millions, trillions and billions of times bigger than the well where he is living. There you see. Therefore, whenever Jupiter is in a difficult dignity, you, whenever you hear that, okay, God is telling this, God is telling that, like Krishna says in the Gita, I am the soul, I am present in everybody's heart, along with the person who is the soul. Ishvara sarva bhutanam hriddeshe arjuna tishthati. I am seated as the father of everybody in the heart. Yes. And the soul is also in the region of the heart. So God is always with the soul. Who is the soul? Soul is you. You are not the body. You are spirit soul. People say that we are having a spiritual experience. No, you are not having a spiritual experience. If you say you are having a spiritual experience, it means you are telling you are a body and you are having a spiritual experience, which is wrong. Actually, it means you are spiritual. You are Sat, Chit, Ananda, full of eternity, knowledge and bliss. Sat, Chit, Ananda means these three things, full of eternity, knowledge and bliss. You are eternal. The soul doesn't die. Nahanyate hanyamane sharire. The soul. Nayanam chindanti shastrani nayanam dahati pavakaha. The soul cannot be cut by, or it cannot be burnt, or you cannot slice it into pieces. The soul is eternal. Chit, sat chit, full of knowledge. You know everything actually on the level of the soul. What does it mean that you know everything? Does it mean that you know all the geography, chemistry, physics of this world? No. Chitta means you are in line with the pure consciousness, which is God. Yes. Therefore, knowing God means that you know everybody. Knowing God doesn't mean you just know God's name or how does he look like. It means when you are completely realized, you are self-realized, you have completely realized who God is, how you are in direct contact with him. And Ananda, Ananda means bliss, Sat Chit Ananda, you are eternally in bliss. So therefore, you are not having a spiritual journey. You are a spirit soul who is in a material journey. There you go. So whenever you hear these kind of dictums that you are a spirit soul, you are not this body, you are like, man, it doesn't seem true to me. Symptoms of a terrible Jupiter. Or even if you believe it, but you are still skeptical. How can that happen? There you see. Because Jupiter is having connection with Rahu, probably in your chart. Maybe, maybe not. Now, what is another symptom? You always run into bad gurus and bad astrologers, bad guides who cheat you, who take money from you. You run into people who force you to do remedies or force you to give gemstones, which do not work. I am not saying remedies do not work or gemstones do not work. I am saying false remedies, false gemstones, which actually does not give you any benefit. You run into these kind of people. That means that some terrible karma you have done. Yes. Now these people are coming to give you back your own karma. And some women, if they have it, then they can be sexually exploited by some guru or by some astrologer. They may say that, okay, if I get to enjoy with you, then if you enjoy with me and if you let me enjoy with you, then you will become this, you will become that. Or you might be cheated monetary wise, either if you are a man or a woman. Either ways it can happen. What is another symptom? Now this is big. You are always eternally pessimistic. Always negative. This is huge. Your Jupiter is very badly spoiled if this is happening. These people, the only thing they do is complain very well. Sounds familiar? Does it sound very familiar? Some people, or maybe we ourselves. Familiarity is very familiar, right? You always complain. You always look down because the trait of Jupiter is urdhva mukha. It always sees up. Up means it sees, okay, whatever has happened, how can we move ahead, how can we see ahead? That is the trait of Jupiter. But when it is terribly spoiled, you don't look up, you look down. Which means you are always looking down to faults, to mistakes. Another symptom is you have a terrible low self-esteem, because Jupiter is the Jiva Karaka. Jupiter Sun represents the Atma and the Jiva. Sun represents the pure consciousness and Jupiter represents the flow of the consciousness. What you love doing in this world, what you feel, that is Jupiter. So when you have a terrible Jupiter, then the symptoms are that you feel as if there's nothing great for you in this world. This world is a terrible place, this world is a miserable place, everybody is a cheater. Especially if women have this, I have seen them. They tell that, oh, people are not very good, especially men, they are all cheaters. No ma'am, no madam, not all men are cheaters. Why are only cheaters getting you? Or why are only you getting cheaters? That's because of your karma. Accept it. Do not blame men. And similarly, with men, I've seen some men, they will say that, oh, these all women are selfish. No, it is not like that. There are many good girls who still exist today. Till today, I know them personally. And also, there are some women who are not that good. But yes, there are good women. There are still. It simply depends on your karma, what kind of people you meet. So if you are going on giving blind dictums that every woman is bad, then well, get well soon, sir. What is another symptom? You cannot continue your spiritual practices. This is another symptom. You lose faith. You lose faith, you gain faith, you lose, gain, lose, gain, lose, gain, lose, gain. That dancing goes on. Dancing means you jump from this spiritual practice to that spiritual practice, to this, to that, to this, to that. And ultimately you become an atheist. You say nothing works. This is another symptom of a difficult Jupiter. Or even if you are in one path, you will always doubt on it. Because the traits of Virgo is not conducive for Jupiter. It's very bad for Jupiter. Virgo is what? Critical analysis. It is opposite of Pisces. Pisces says, okay, do it, try your best and leave the rest to God. That's what Pisces says. Virgo says, no. Why God? I will do it myself. Why am I not getting results? Yes. Another symptom is, this can happen. This depends on so many other factors. Another symptom is, spiritual practices don't positively affect you. The same mantra somebody is chanting and they are getting benefit. But getting benefit means their overall life is improving, depending on what mantra that is. But the same mantra you are chanting, but it's not benefiting you. Now you will say, oh my God, mantras don't work. No, it is not the mantra. It is your faith and your efforts to chant the mantra in a proper mood and attitude. Because when you externally chant the mantra, you are activating the fifth house from the lagna. Because fifth house is the house of the mantra. You are chanting some mantra, maybe Om Namah Shivaya, Om Gana Ganapataye Namah. Some mantra you are chanting. But from the moon, the fifth house will only get active when you have faith in the mantra. You are doing it with all heart and soul. There you see. If that is not happening, just if you activate the fifth house from the lagna, it's useless. It's not entirely useless. It can give you some benefits, but those are also very minimal. Minimal, nominal, whatever you call it. It's in Hindi, you say, na ke barabar. It simply means if somebody is getting benefited and you are not getting benefited. Now, I'm not telling you to compare, but I'm seeing that I have seen some people. So many mantras they will chant, but it doesn't affect them positively. Why? Because they are not doing it with sincerity. And sincerity will come only with a good Jupiter. Yes. What is another symptom? You have quarrel with your gurus or with your guru. You do not get along well with them. You always rebel. You always say no to whatever they say. Another symptom is you cannot hear good advice. This is huge. Even if people are giving you good advice, you will still not listen to it. You will only do what you want. Majority of the people of this world, that is why they are suffering, because they do not pay heed to the word of the scriptures. They will only do whimsically whatever they want. Manorathena sati dhavato bahi. They are going on in the chariot of the mind today, from this boy to that girl, from this man to this woman, from this job to that job, from business to MBA, from masters to PhD. Okay, that's the symptom. You cannot hear good advice from the guru. Or first of all, if that's very bad, badly spoiled, then you will not even get good advice of the guru. You will run into bad gurus, as I said. What is another symptom? Another symptom is you lack overall contentment and fulfillment in life. Whatever you do in life, you don't feel happy. You feel there is something missing, feel there is something lacking. Alright, these are the typical symptoms. And of course, Jupiter is also the significator of family. It is also the significator of expansion, growth, wisdom. You go after knowledge. You go after information. You do not go after knowledge, wisdom. That is another symptom. You read all the scriptures, but you do not know what is the conclusion. That is another symptom. And as I said, the earlier symptom is also very prominent, that even if you take to some spiritual practice, you will always leave it, or you will keep changing. Bang on. Today this, tomorrow that. Today this, tomorrow that. Every day it's keep changing. So these are the symptoms. Quarrels with guru, lack of faith and determination, skepticism, doubts. Doubt doesn't mean it is wrong to doubt, but the questions which is asked by a spiritual seeker is in a mood to understand the answer. It is not in a mood to challenge the person who is speaking. For example, if you go to a satsang, which is a holy program which goes on in India, and in West you call it meet or something, a holy program basically in the church or in the mosque. Suppose the priest or the father or the pujari is giving you a lecture on some topic, on Ramayana. And then you ask, then you are like, oh, he said this, no, wait, I will ask him now. Let me test him how much he knows. If that is the reason why you are asking question, or the same thing you can do with astrologers. There was a person who once took a consultation from me. I will not tell whether it was a he or a she. So this person, for reference, I will use the word he. But maybe he is a she also. So this person, he contacted me, and I said, and he told me that something had happened to my father's life when he was young. Can you tell me what had happened? I said, but what will you do by knowing that, because that has already gone. Then he or she said, no, actually I just want to test how accurate astrology is. I just want to see, can you pinpoint that event? I said, every day there can be millions of things that are happening. Yes, at least you have to tell me what it is related to, body or health or what it is. I mean, related to education. Otherwise, how can I just, because every day something or the other is happening. It is not possible for any astrologer to decode it like that. Maybe there is some super astrologer, but at least I am not in a level to do all those. I am not Parashara. That you just ask and anything can be told. Then I said to her, no, I can't tell that. That too, you are not telling me the year. If you tell me the year, then I can tell you what has happened. But you are not telling me the year also. And then later she told me that when her father was at the age of 13, then he got a major injury in the arm, and then later on he had some terrible disease because of that. So this is what he told me. And then I told him that, sir, that's okay, very nice to know that. But these people I have seen, they will test astrologers, they will test people like this. Yes, and you always want to take revenge. You cannot forgive. The sign of Pisces is the sign of forgiveness. You cannot forgive people. This is another big symptom. You always keep grudges. You are always negative. These are typical symptoms. Well, now, what is the cure? If Jupiter is terrible, what is the cure? The cure is very simple. Whichever spiritual practice you are doing, do it more diligently, do it more committedly, do it more with attention, with faith. Hear from the sadhus, read the scriptures, improve your Jupiter by that. By that, your Jupiter will naturally improve. Because when you read the scriptures, you will understand, when you go a bit deeper, everything makes sense. Yes, everything makes sense. Like Krishna says in the Gita, Dukhalaya Mashashvatam, that this world is a place of misery, you will not get happiness. Is that not true? You see, people are having millions of dollars. They are having the most charming, attractive spouse. They are having everything sometimes. And why are they committing suicides? Yes, recently there was a great singer from a band who committed suicide. There was a comedian last few years back who committed suicide. There are so many people committing suicide. So many people are miserable. So many people are having divorces. The question is not what they are having. The question is, even if they have so much, why are they still miserable? That the Gita answers. Because you are disconnected from the source of happiness. Raso vaisaha. So what is the solution? You try to connect back to God. That is the solution. By that, you will gain more happiness and you will be fulfilled. By that, you will be more forgiving, more tolerant. You will have more, you will be very broad-minded in your approach. Yes. These are the remedies for a difficult, afflicted, terrible Jupiter. All right. That is it from my side. If you have any questions, queries or comments, then let me know in the comment section. And if you want a consultation from me, then approach me in my mail or in WhatsApp. And if you have not subscribed to the channel, then subscribe to it below. Until next time, wish you good luck with your debilitated, afflicted, terrible, downtrodden, miserable Jupiter. Until next time, bye bye. See you.